Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Yeah, I'm redoing this video I already made last night about who's the Antichrist. I'm redoing it. I just realized yesterday that I was making a video, or maybe it's today or yesterday, is actually, I believe, the birthday of the Prince William. I am not prophesying or predicting who is the Antichrist, but all the things the Lord showed me, and what the Bible says, and lots of other sources, seems to be he is the candidate in a thousand different directions that point to him. Sounds impossible, sounds unbelievable. It may not be him. Why am I talking about it? Well, the Lord's, led me studying this. Who's the Antichrist? And for the last 3 years, almost exclusively, the Lord's had me studying, how it's all coming together. Been studying the end times for 12 years, since the year 2000. And all the times before, I studied, all about the signs of the end times and what the Lord was doing and all that. And the return of the Lord and all those things, the rapture. But the last 3 years, since I moved to this place that I'm in right now, I started renting a house here in the city so I could have an internet and all those things. Anyway, since I moved here, the Lord just keeps, taking me and showing me step by step, from the Tower of Babel, the fall in the Garden of Eden to the Tower of Babel, through Egypt, satanic worship and all that, how it all ties in together today. And then I'm like almost at the end of that study. So I'm almost there where the Lord wants me to go with this information. So I would say the good thing about that is, I believe that it's time for the Lord to come, because it says that the son of destruction, perdition, that word there is Apollyon from the book of Revelation. The spirit that either, I've made videos. If you go to my channel, under this video you'll see that Near to Christ, too. Click on that, go to my channel. I made videos way back when I started this channel, maybe last July, almost a year ago. And I still believe, what I've studied, that it's possible that the Antichrist will be, because he's called the Beast. In the book of Revelation, he's never called Antichrist. It's only in 1 John. He's called the Beast. There's the first beast and the second beast. Okay, and so Beast, is a creature, and, and then it talks about Apollyon coming out of the bottomless pit, and the Beast will kill the two witnesses and all this, the first beast, who we call the Antichrist. So it's possible that he is the fallen angel Apollyon, which it means destroyer, destruction. So when it talks about him entering perdition, in the Greek it's saying he enters Apollyon, enters a human. And of course, lots of scholars, like the Left Behind books, if you read those, and they're, pretty good theology from Dr. Tim LaHaye, and, kind of along the lines of your traditional evangelical doctrine, when the Antichrist is allegedly killed and then resurrects from the dead in the middle of the tribulation, that's when he'll really start claiming to be God, and then that's the time he'll become possessed by Apollyon. But it could be Apollyon himself coming as a man, as I'll just repeat, that in the Bible, there's angels that appeared at Sodom and Gomorrah, and they thought they were men, but they were actually angels. So there's, and then Joshua saw a man, but it turned out he was the angel, the captain of the Lord's host. But he appeared as a man to Joshua. So it could be that the Antichrist and false prophet, who are the first beast and the second beast, and as they're called in the book of Revelation, could actually be fallen angels who come back. So I've made videos saying that, that all this alien stuff, a UFO lands, they step out and say, hey, we created you from the Sumerian. Anything I'm mentioning here, just Google it, look it up. If you don't know about it, check it out on Wikipedia. The Sumerian tablets talk about the aliens, space travelers or whatever, who created the humans, through DNA manipulation. And, of course, I believe the biblical answer is that they're fallen angels. The fallen angels from Genesis chapter 6. In the days of Noah, Jesus said, as the days of Noah were, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. So it'll either be a man, and I believe it'll be Prince William possessed by Apollyon, or it will actually be Apollyon himself. But let me just go through some things. Just a few minutes ago, I'm trying to make this cohesive and coherent as I can, and it's so much information. I want to mention many different things, and you can just go Google it and check it out. Read all about these topics that I'll hit that point to this thing, because it's a ton of information. I could go on and on and on for, you know, do a whole college class on it. And more. Because it's just so much information. But anyway, then the Bible, it talks about, I can't remember now. Let me go through some other information. I'll come back to it. How about the beast? So it's possible that it's a polyam. Okay. What makes me think that it's Prince William? Okay, it's for one thing that, the Lord had showed me stuff all about kind of like the Da Vinci Code stuff, but instead of it being the bloodline of these, you know, illegitimate children of Jesus, it's the bloodline of the serpent seed, you know, whatever, the bloodline that would bring forth the Antichrist. Now, the Lord also showed me and keeps telling me to study about the Knights Templar. So when we look at the Knights Templar, okay, we see that, if you can go Google about the Da Vinci Code or watch it and see what I'm talking about. I haven't seen the movie. I've read all about it on the internet. So anyway, in that movie, instead of coming up with the descendants of Jesus, come up with the Antichrist. And in that, which is the truth, this part's about the Merovingian dynasty. Okay, they claim to be the descendants of Christ. Actually, it goes into the, you know, they're working with the Knights Templar, protected by the Knights Templar. Okay, the Knights Templar escaped when they were persecuted by King Philip of France. Some of them made it to Scotland. There's supposed to be that Roslyn Chapel there and all of that. Okay, they started the Jacobites, the followers of King James II, the House of Stuart. Any of these things I mentioned, you can Google and check it out because I'm just boom, boom, boom going through this information. So the thing is that Prince William himself, from his mother's side, okay, is she's from the House of Stuart, okay, and she's also, you know, what's in the Jacobites. Look up Bonnie Prince Charles if you want to see about that, the Jacobites. But, because I made the other video, I went to, started getting into this, but you can't, you know, it's just too detailed, and you got to stay, I'm trying to stay on track. Okay, a Bible verse in the book of Revelation, it says that the first beast, the Antichrist, will rise out of the sea. Second beast comes out of the land, okay? So they say, in biblical interpretation, when it says comes out of the sea, it means out of the Sea of Nations, out of the Gentile nations, and then out the land, it's talking about out of the land of Israel. So if that's true in that interpretation that all lots of these, you know, expert scholars say, then the Antichrist should be coming from a Gentile nation and the false prophet from the land of Israel. And the Lord was just showing me this just 30 minutes ago. But I will say this. It's also true and would make sense that the Antichrist would, you know, claim to be the king of the Israelites. So therefore, he'd have to be a descendant of King David or from the house of Israel. So, you know, the kings of England and all them, they have their tradition saying and claiming that they're descendants of King David, okay? They already say that. But it also is a fact, and I just saw a news article about 6 months ago, a secular news article, they weren't even talking about this, but they said that, you know, it's just been discovered recently or revealed publicly that Lady Diana, has lots of Jewish blood. And then, you know, you inherit, if you're a Jew, it comes from your mother's side, not your father's side. So Prince William is Jewish from his mother's side. So he does have Jewish blood. And then even his wife is actually a descendant of Aaron on her mother's side. Okay, so maybe it'll be their child. But that would, if that's true, then it'll be 30 years from now before the Antichrist come to power. And I believe it's now is the time. Tons of reasons. Made videos about that. Look at my website. All the signs are here for the return of the Lord. But, okay, so Princess Diana's son, Prince William, or, you know, if something happened to him, it could be his brother, Harry. But anyway, Prince William, there's lots of things about him. They say he's born on the summer solstice. And, you know, I made this video yesterday. Like I said, I just realized it was his birthday, 30th birthday, you know. And then, of course, if you follow, you know, if it's going to be soon, 2012, you know, he'd have to be coronated this year. But anyway, there's so many different angles and stuff I've just been looking at. It's also true that the royals want to come back to power. Okay, the royals want to come back to power. Now, if you follow this, the Knights Templar, okay, you can study about that. They became the Jesuits that we have now. Now, the Jesuits are sworn to destroy. This is documented. They're sworn allegiance to the Pope to restore, you know, God-given rule of these, divine right to rule of these kings of Europe who claim to be descendants of King David. They claim, you know, that all this, but actually it's the Antichrist spirit. So the Bible talks about 10 kings in Revelation and Daniel, about 10 kings ruling. And then it talks about the Antichrist being a king of fierce countenance and all of this, and a little horn and all that. So I would say that, you know, what the Lord showed me and what the Bible is saying is that the Antichrist will be of royal bloodline, or, you know, he'll be a king. So that's why, even though Obama has lots of interesting things about him, he's not a king. He's not in a royal position. He's an elected politician. And democracy and freedom and all that, freedom of religion and all that, even though it's good, but, you know, it's against what the royals want to do. They want to dictate, you know, take the mark or we'll chop off your head, you know, whatever, like the Catholic Church used to do, you know. They had the Inquisition and persecuting people and all that. So the rule of the kings is my way or the highway. You know, they, like King Henry, you know, declared himself the head of the church. Not even, you know, even though the Pope is not in this authority that he claims to be. You know, Jesus is the head of the church. But anyway, so they're in cahoots because, you know, the Pope used to make the royals even, you know, he made one king of France even stand in the rain and no shoes on outside his door for 3 days. You know, he'd tell him, oh, you'll go to hell because I've excommunicated you before he reinstated him or whatever. So that king believed that without the dying in a state of grace and blessings by the Pope, you know, without the last rites from the Pope or receiving communion, he couldn't be in a state of grace. That's what Catholicism teaches. So they came up with all these convenient doctrines that means like, hey, you know, your salvation is through the church. If you don't have the approval of the bishop, you know, we can excommunicate you. We can deny your communion. We can deny your relationship with the Lord. We hold the keys to heaven. And that's the teaching of the Catholic Church. So then the kings and them have been in cahoots through what we call the Dark Ages because they wouldn't allow anybody to read the Bible. It was only in Latin, and it was only spoken in Latin in their masses and all that. So that's what they call the Dark Ages, you know, until God made a way for the Last Days Church. Really, the Last Days, as far as the body of Christ is concerned, really started like in the time of Martin Luther. It really took off, you know. And then even though King Henry got divorced and it was a bad thing, you know, he broke from the Catholic Church for the purpose of, you know, getting a male heir so he could get divorced. And even though all that was bad, but the end result was, you know, we got the Bible in English and then opened the door for Christianity to hit the whole world. And the last 500 years, you know, the Lord, by his grace, has made a way that, you know, the gospel's covered the whole earth. The commission of the church has been fulfilled. It's time for us to go. So they're going to go back to those dark ages. You know, that seven-year period is going to be connected in. So, let's see. I've mentioned several things about the thing. Let me look at my notes real quick. So anyway, another thing that's pretty interesting that connects to this that I never heard anywhere else. I just read it on the internet the other day, 2 days ago maybe, is that Christopher Columbus, you know, I've read before that he was Jewish secretly and then faked himself to be a Catholic. And you know that in 1492 they killed a bunch of Jews there in Spain, drove them out of Spain, and same time that Christopher Columbus was being sent to the New World. But anyway, from Portugal. But the father-in-law of Christopher Columbus was what they called the Knights Templar. They're the Knights of Christ. And in Portugal, they were not done away with like they were in France, the Knights Templar. But they changed their name a little bit to the Knights of Christ and dropped the Templar part. And then Christopher Columbus sailed on ships from the Knights Templar. You know, and so their ships is the white background with the red cross. And then, you know, I'd had a vision back there in December 21st, 2011. I had a vision of these ships coming, you know, and I made a video about the, you know, I thought the Lord was, you know, showing me like the movie Apocalypse. It was like the end of that movie, what I saw, you know, and it was like the end of the new world, the end of the way of life for the Indians. It was the revealing of the, you know, the Christianity going to the New World, even though they were Catholics, but that kind of a concept. But, you know, it's also that, you know, the United States and all that, what the enemy wanted to make, like this Sir Francis Bacon and all them, those guys wanted to have the New Atlantis. I mean, that's what they believe in. I mean, it's all this stuff. You know, they want to restore the British nobility and the European nobility, even though they're still around, but they don't have power. They want, you know, the Queen of England is not in power. They want to come back to power. You know, they want to rule the world. And so that's really what's going on. The nobility is hiding behind. Really, the Illuminati is finance. Everybody keeps talking about the Rothschilds. They're the financiers. They are Jewish blood, but they are not practicing Israelites. They're evil people, obviously. There's lots of people that claim they're Christian and they're evil, you know, like President Bush claimed to be a Christian, but he goes to Bohemian Grove. Look that up if you never heard of it. Worshiping the big owl and making a sacrifice, cremation of care to the big owl. He laughed when that woman who became a Christian out there that was put to death. I remember in Texas when he was a governor, there was a woman put to death. I forgot her name. She became a Christian, and then he didn't stay her execution, had her killed. That's justice. But the thing is that they were interviewing him, and he was like laughing about it and stuff. It's on YouTube. And, President Bush, he may be retarded. That may be his excuse. But anyway, these people are wicked people. And his father, very wicked man. They're all blue bloods, meaning that they're, when you think about that term blue blood, you're talking about that reptilian blood. I don't know if they're, possessed by or actually, intermingled with the fallen angels or whatever. It doesn't matter. There's all these different things about it. All these things are real, brothers and sisters. All these things are real. The wickedness of these people is unbelievable. And so I'm going to cut off my video. I'm trying to think of what else I can tell you. I need to make more videos about this, brothers and sisters. But all the information I have, everything I'm looking at, Crawford references back to Prince William or one of the royals. I mean, it could be one of the royals of the other houses, but he has all the traits, so like I said, he's from the sea, the beast that rides out of the sea. He's from the Gentile nations. And, England is the sons of Tarshish in the Bible, and they're out there in the sea. So as a matter of fact, they're also, the sea net going nation. That really is a good description of the British Isles anyway. And then the Anglos is supposed to be the British angels, and of course there's fallen angels. And there's so many different things in my mind that I'm trying to say to finish this video. There's lots of moral reasons that I need to make another video about. There's just tons of information. I made notes, lots of notes, which I usually don't make good notes, but I tried to make good notes to make it more coherent, brothers and sisters, and put it all together. I will come back, make a new video to add more points. But I would say that, as I said, I will say that Prince William is the number one candidate right now in my mind, or some other royal who would meet the criteria. And they're all inbred anyway, so it's, all the other ones probably have most of these same things too. But Prince William has the Jewish blood too, so guaranteed Jewish blood from his mother's side that's documented. So he has claimed that. And then he's from the blood descendants, which is the Merovingians and then the Jacobites. They have a claim back to that to the King of Jerusalem in 1099, the first grand there, the beginning of the Knights Templar. He has that blood in him also. So I'm trying to think of his name, de Bullion. I forgot his first name, de Bullion. He has that bloodline. He has all of those traits, and he's the right age. He was born on the summer solstice. I've even heard some people saying that, they took blood from the Shroud of Turin, and then they, spliced it in or made it from his DNA. That's pretty far-fetched, but who knows? These people actually believe. And his middle name is Arthur. One of his names is Arthur, so the story of Arthur and the Round Table, they really believe that story. He will take the name King Arthur. And so all that mythology and mysticism, they actually believe that stuff. And they believe that they can really do that and live that. Like Merlin is a false prophet, Merlin the magician, and all these things. Those, if you go back and look at all that mythology, that's really what they believe. Like Prince Charles, he's really into his relative, who we get Dracula from, Vlad the Impaler. He's really into that. He just had a big thing about it, and he's really into it. And that's an evil guy. And they're also, the word Gothic comes from their name. Their real last name is Gotha. The current Queen of England, their name is Saxe Coburn Gotha, like Gothic. And Prince Charles, I would say, if I could think of a picture of someone of Gothic, he is very Gothic face. I mean, he's a creepy looking guy. But anyway, the Antichrist, like Prince William is example too, it's not really a creepy looking guy. He's a charismatic, exciting guy, it seems like the opposite of evil, and that's just what the Antichrist is going to be. So he has the personality and all that too, also be, very charismatic and all of that. So it's possible, and it seems that everything is pointing to him.